بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، dear all, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to ease all our pain as we witness the passing of the month of Ramadan. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst the inspired during these remaining days of this blessed month, as well as to make us from amongst those that witness the night of power. Ameen. My dear brothers and sisters, you have come together, alhamdulillah, upon goodness and upon piety. And this is something which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commands us towards in His book when He says, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. For you have come together to discuss the greatest obligation, and that is at-tawheed, and matters related to at-tawheed, and matters related to the protection of at-tawheed. Now, my dear brothers, my dear sisters, this topic of Tawheed, for some reason or the other, is a topic not discussed as much as it should be. We find a range of topics related to the Islamic sciences being discussed in the masajid, being discussed in the madaris. We find speakers speaking about a range of topics, but very few actually discuss this concept and this topic of Tawheed. It may be a case that societies don't ask for this topic because they feel it is one which is clear, one which they know. But the reality is, O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, we can never ever discuss this topic enough. For At-Tawheed is the essence behind everything in creation. This topic of Tawheed is the reason behind Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sending prophets. The reason behind Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealing books. And this Tawheed is a means of honor, both in this world and the hereafter. We know that At-Tawheed was the criteria with all the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them to a people and they called them towards Tawheed. This was the message of Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this was the message of Nuh alayhi salam. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala eloquently says in his book, وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ فَقَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. لا إله إلا الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we indeed sent Nuh to his people. And he said to them, worship Allah. مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. There is no other ilah worthy of worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala further says, وَإِلَىٰ مَدْيَنَ أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and to the people of Madian, we sent their brother Shu'ayb, and he told them, worship Allah. مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. There is no one worthy of worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِلَىٰ ثَمُودَ أَخَاهُمْ صَالِحًا قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and we sent to the people of Thamud their brother Salih. What did Salih tell them? اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ. Worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرُهُ. There is no one worthy of worship besides one Allah, رَبُّ الْعِزَّةِ وَالْجَلَالِ الْوَاحِدُ الْقَهَّارِ الْأَحَدُ الْفَرْدُ الصَّمَدُ الَّذِي لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. O servants of Allah, this is the reality of what you have come together to discuss. وَلِلَّهِ الْحَمْدُ. This concept of Tawheed is a means of honor for us, both in this world and in the hereafter. After all, it was Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu who said, كنا أذلا. We were wretched. نحن قوم أعزل الله بالإسلام. We are a قوم, a people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted honor because of Islam. سبحان ربي الأعلى. And what about the famous story of the great Sahabi who stood in front of Rustam, a man of financial standing, a man of material well-being, a man of great placement on earth, and the Sahabi stood in front of him. And when he was asked why he came, he boldly, with honor, answered and said, لِنُخْرِجَ الْعِبَادِ مِنْ عِبَادَةِ الْعِبَادِ إلى عبادة رب العباد. We have come to remove the ibad, the worshippers, من عبادة العباد, from worshipping the worshippers, إلى عبادة رب العباد, to the worship of the Lord of the worshippers. لا إله إلا الله. This concept of توحيد, O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, is a means of honor in the year after as well. Look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised the mention of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And it wasn't raised except because of his great tawheed, his great worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his great belief in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his great conviction in the oneness of Allah, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal al Wahidul Qahhar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the statement of Yusuf alayhi salam. Yusuf alayhi salam says, وَاتَّبَعْتُ مِلَّةَ آبَائِي إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْحَاقِ, and I have followed the way of my fathers. Now, the father of Yusuf alayhi salam was Yaqub, and the father of Yaqub was Ishaq, and the father of Ishaq was Ibrahim alayhi salam. Thus, it was in perfect order for him to say, my fathers Yaqub, Ishaq, and Ibrahim. But rather, Yusuf alayhi salam mentions Ibrahim wa Ishaq wa Yaqub. La ilaha illallah. He brings Ibrahim forward, for this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has exalted the mention of Ibrahim alayhi salam. And it wasn't but because of his tawheed and the level of his tawheed. And indeed, Ibrahim has a great placement in the hereafter. Understand, O servants of Allah and O children of Adam, how important this topic is. Indulge in it, discuss it, and do everything in your capacity to ensure that it is protected. For in our society today, despite us believing that tawheed is not as important as the other topics that need to be discussed, we find elements in our society that say, touch wood. We find elements in our society that say, fingers crossed. And they don't even know what they're saying. وَيَحْسَبُونَهُ هَيِّنًا وَهُوَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ عَظِيمٌ. They don't know what they're saying. They're speaking without ilm, and they think it is just a minor word and a minor statement, but by Allah, it is a great statement with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our mistakes. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us if we ever associated partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knowingly and unknowingly. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from ever associating partners with him knowingly. I love you all for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And thank you all for your sa'i, for your action, for your activeness and coming together. And I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes your sitting a means of proactivity. I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees us to meet face to face in this dunya one day. And if not, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to gather us underneath his arsh on the day of Qiyamah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well to gather us in Jannah with Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.